table for two, please.
Hello, mga KaTable!
Welcome to our very first episode of our KaTable series. Basically, yung KaTable series is that we are going to feature a guest for each episode, and we will be talking about a topic that relates to them or that relates to overseas Filipino workers.
Katulad ng unang guest natin ngayon. Siya yung aking pinsan.
Yes, and she's also my very good friend and my future cousin-in-law, colleague, and ano pa ba, ex-housemate rin namin. Siya si
Marielle.
Yel.
Ah, Yel. Marami siyang mga pangalan eh, pero favorite color niya, yellow.
Labo!
Si Yel daw siya. Hello.
Here's Yel.
Hi, Marielle.
Hello, mga KaTable!
Bakit ba natin siya invite?
Kasi Yel is very knowledgeable and experienced sa long-distance relationship, which is very, hindi naman trending. Pero
trending? Uso ba ngayon yun?
Oh, well, medyo na uso kasi nga, di ba, pandemic, COVID season. So, there are other people who are in a relationship with people who are overseas, not necessarily foreigners, but basically far away from their loved ones or lovers. Oo okay. Nga, paano ka naging overseas Filipino
worker? Overseas Filipino worker, ang haba naman. Kasi back in 2012, na-inspire ako kay Kevin, my cousin! It was
curiosity.
Really out of curiosity, and Prichie here was my ex-colleague from JWT Manila.
Yeah.
And then, na-inspire din siya, sinundan ako.
So, parang so,
nauna siya, sumunod ako, tapos siya naman sumunod.
Yes. Okay, back to the reason why we're talking to you about...
Wait!
What?
Nakita niyo ba yung...
Oh, yeah!
Oh, my God!
Nice.
Thank you so much, Yel, for the
lovely jacket and so with our
merch
logo.
Nina.
First merch, kami yung bumili.
Binigay.
Sponsored yan, ha?
Tell us about your background story with Luigi.
Back in 2015.
Nakalimutan.
Nag-meet kami ni Luigi through Tinder.
Kala ko Lazada.
So, no, Taobao. Taobao Italy edition. Ciao. Taobao. Through Tinder, siya yung second kong date. And then yon, nag-meet kami mga October. So he was here working my project siya for like a couple of months. Tapos yun, may Tinder din siya, may Tinder ako, tapos yun na.
Tinder-Tindera na kayo.
Gano'ng katagal na kayo nagde-date?
More than 5 years.
And he's from?
He's from Italy.
He's Italy.
Ciao!
He's Italian.
Hello to the family of Luigi, if in case you guys get to watch this.
Ciao, amore!
Ever since we started, LDR kami. Pero when we met, may work siya dito for a few months, and then yun.
Ano bang work ni Luigi?
Sa ship, sa construction, like mga interior retrofitting.
So technically, you always see each other, di ba? So whether you go on vacation or nandito naman siya to work.
Oh, so at least every year pumupunta ako sa Italy during my birthday month. And then most of the time siya talaga yung nagta-travel dito, either it's for vacation or for work. Madalas for work.
Anyway, so yun, since pandemic ngayon, COVID season, syempre lahat ng mga long-distance relationship couples sobrang affected with all these, diba? So when you first found out na maglo-lockdown na yung countries, what did you think about it and what did Luigi think about it? What was your initial thought?
When COVID started, he was here. Si Luigi's always been like the type na, okay, let's take it one day at a time. So that's how we took it. And hindi siya yung parang mahirap for me and for us nung first few months. Kasi parang the whole world was in lockdown, di ba? Tapos parang everyone was like going through the same thing. Nagkaroon kami ng routine during that lockdown. Although hindi naman ganun kadami yung activities kasi nasa house lang kami. Like exercising, ganyan. Tapos siya nagluluto ng mga bread.
So at that point, hindi pa yun masyadong depressing?
Oh, hindi pa siya ganun ka-depressing. And parang feeling ko hindi din kasi ganun pa nagsisink in, like no one really knew the extent of this. Actually, nung time na yun, kaya din siguro I was feeling okay, or like both of us, kasi we were looking forward to something, which was him going to Singapore kasi dapat may job siya dito ng August of 2020. Oh, and then, okay. Na-move nang na-move. So, kunwari, hindi natuloy ng August. Tapos, tatanungin niya yung office. Parang, baka ano, September, October, November. Tapos, parang November, that's when it hit me and him. Na parang, oh no, parang hindi ka talaga makakapunta dito for work. I think that was one of the main reasons kung bakit okay kami nung mga first few months.
So, di na kayo okay ngayon?
Okay na,
so, break na pala sila.
Wala na palang LDR break. Siyempre, since LDR kayo, meron na kayong routine on how to communicate with each other. So, nag-continue na lang yun.
Nag-research ako, tapos meron one big Facebook group na sinusundan ko talaga is like yung Love is Not Tourism. I'm sure like everyone who's in a long distance relationship knows about this or should know about this group. So, nag-petition yung group na to sa iba't ibang mga countries na you should open your borders to couples na in a long distance relationship or like multinational couples like me and Luigi.
Cousin!
Hey, cousin!
Ano pala yung mga challenges nyo na-encounter, katulad yung mga away-away, LQ.
So, yung challenges, syempre, like, feeling of loneliness. Like, for example, like, a lot of people think that I'm strong, pero, like, towards the end of this, parang, oh, when will this end? Tas, sumabay pa yung gloomy season, yung holiday season, and mix of, like, not being with your family and all. Minsan, tinotopak ako, tas ako yung magpo-provoke ng away.
Paano?
Wala, yung sobrang malulungkot lang ako. Tapos, awayin ko si Luigi.
paano ba nag-aaway kapag online?
Yung magagalit lang ako, tapos magdadrama.
Tantrums.
Oo, tantrum. Lalo na kapag it's that time of the month na parang, why are we still in a long-distance relationship? Blah, 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 blah. One thing na naparealize sa akin ni Luigi, kasi like usually it's me pouring out my emotions. Pero like sinabi niya sa akin na, you should also understand me kasi I'm trying to be strong, like act strong and all. Pero syempre, I want to lift you up. I want to lift your emotions and not show na I'm also going through what you're going through. So yun yung sinasabi niya sa akin na parang minsan hindi ko na-realize na inisip ko ako lang yung malungkot, ako lang yung lonely, pero siya din. Pero hindi niya pinapakita yun sa akin, pero sinabi niya sa akin na he's also feeling that. Hindi ko din alam kung paano niya natitake yung mga topak ko.
Okay, so how do you and Luigi make things work? Especially these days, diba? Are there any added efforts na you were doing or he is doing compared to pre-COVID season?
Nung nag-start yung COVID, diba nga nagka-routine kami? Tapos nagkaroon kami ng like mga ideas, for example, like what I can do when I move to Italy. Mm. So that's what kept me preoccupied for like a couple of months. Online dating na kunwari kakain ng wine, tapos yung partner yun, iinom na wine. Tapos sa kabilang video, umiinom na ng wine. Although hindi naman namin yung ginagawa.
Ah, so never nyo ba ginawa yun? Yung parang
hindi.
Some activity. Of those people are actually doing that to
oh, okay. Siguro yung ginagawa namin, exercising together.
Oh, that's one thing. One kind of, ano. Siguro so, iba lang yung interest.
Kailangan natin mag-exercise ulit, okay?
Ah, you're talking to Luigi.
She's talking to Luigi. Bigla na lang eh. Okay.
Hindi nagpasabi eh. May shout-out ka, magsabi ka.
Okay, so Yael, how do you cope with, you know, this current situation nga, now that you're in it?
Well, kasi kami naman, ever since, as in constant communication, like FaceTime, selfies.
What do you mean by that? What kind of selfies?
Normal selfies!
Selfies raw!
Wala naman kaming ginagawang like extras compared to pre-COVID in terms of like communication kasi nag-start naman kaming madalas talaga nag-uusap and if we have problems, pag-uusapan namin kaagad. As in, very straightforward ako, pati si Luigi. I mean,
yeah,
as in,
we can attest to that.
And in terms of taking care of my mental health, tinanggal ko yung Instagram ko nung December kasi yun yung I felt at my loneliest. 10 months. I think this is the longest we've been away from each other. And it's really good to communicate with your partner. Like, for example, if you're feeling lonely, tell him that you're feeling lonely. Kasi wag mo itago, tas hindi niya alam kung why you're feeling that way. At least tell him or her. And yun nga, katulad nung sinabi ko kanina, they're also going through the same thing. So don't just think na you're alone in this. Kasi magkasama kayo ng partner mo. So it also helps na i-acknowledge mo yung feelings mo, even if it's like bad.
Uy, LDR din tayo.
Hindi ah.
Living room, dining room.
He really improved his English.
Mm.
Ikaw ba?
Kasi important kasi
in-improve
yun eh.
Mo ba yung Italian?
Hindi, kailangan ko mag-step up.
Oo, kasi kailangan yun, di ba? Parang two sides yun. Siya, nagbibigay siya ng effort. Tapos ikaw, anong effort ang binibigay mo?
Oo, oh, grabe siya.
Ano ba yung na-miss mo sa old normal?
Siyempre, yung convenience of traveling. Siyempre, traveling is really a big thing kapag LDR ka, di ba? Ang daming couples affected. Lalo na nung, ano yun? Yung sa groups nga. As in, sobrang helpful niya for me. Kasi ang dami kong na-meet doon na ibang mga tao na in a long-distance relationship. Kasi nag-post ako doon parang, I'm so happy to find this group, ganyan, ganyan, ganyan. Parang may dalawang Pinoy nag-message sa akin na, uy, Pinoy din ako, tas yung partner ko nasa Italy din.
Oo, oh, same talaga, pati yung partners nila sa Italy din.
Ang bait nila, mag-a-update sila if ever may news na pwedeng maka-travel kami or sila, although wala namang news.
Mine naman, I did find other people who were also stuck here in Singapore and then are having problems, you know, with their wedding. Kasi like kami ni Kevin, ayun, na-cancel yung wedding because of the pandemic. So it also helps when you actually talk to someone with the same situation. You know that they understand how you feel and what you're going through.
Mm-hmm.
So not just with your partner, but also with similar, yun nga, couples who are going.
Yeah, as in sobrang helpful na, like, it doesn't really have to be a close friend.
Kasi ano yun, kasi parang masyadong complacent ka na dun sa friend mo na maririndi ka na sa sasabihin niya na paulit-ulit. Parang gusto mo rin makakilala ng ibang tao na,
yeah, that's true.
Ano, na makaka-relate talaga sa'yo. Eh, yung mga friend mo na kinukuhanan mo ng advice,
hindi naman nakaka-relate.
Oo, kaya, diba? As in, sobrang helpful. So, ngayon ko lang na-appreciate yung Facebook. As in, ang dami kong Facebook groups na related to the pandemic na nagawa dahil sa pandemic.
Mm. Once na nag-open na yung borders ng Singapore and Italy, ano yung una-una mong gagawin?
Siyempre, magbubook.
Going to Italy. Grabe.
Sana.
Ah, so, unang-una mong gagawin is to book to Italy, hindi sa Manila?
Oo. Oh.
Talaga?
OFW.
Okay, so ano na lang yung advice mo sa mga ibang couples?
Ka-LDR.
Oh, ka-LDR. Mga long-distance relationships. Mga people who are going through long-distance relationships.
So, my advice would be to have a constant communication with your partner. That really helps. And I'm sure mahirap sabihin lahat ng feelings nyo. If may nararamdaman kayo or napapansin na iba, just like initiate the conversation. May iba kasing couples na they try to keep it to themselves and leave their partners like guessing what you're going through.
Yeah, that's true.
Be flexible. Not naman flexible, pero be open to change.
Or don't expect too much. Like
from other party.
I feel like I get more depressed when I believe my expectations too much. Na I know that this is going to happen. Whatever hopes I have, it's going to happen. But when it comes to the point na hindi siya matutuloy, mas syempre you feel worse than before.
Oh, kaya kailangan yung pagiging flexible na sinasabi niya, yung mentally yun. Kasi kung hindi flexible yung pag-iisip mo na pag-give way to one another, kung merong tantrums katulad ng sinabi ni Marielle na gusto niya lang maggawa ng sariling fight. Tapos
nangunguna
yun yung other side naman yung kailangan maging flexible, diba?
Yeah. Wag sabayan.
Wag niyo sabayan.
And I'm super happy na si Luigi hindi niya ako sinasabayan.
Yeah, I'm also kasi, happy about that.
Kung sabayan niya ako, ewan ko na lang kung ano nangyari sa amin.
Yeah, sobrang perfect na yan. It balances the relationship as well. Okay. Yeah, that's a very good advice for those who are on LDR. Ikaw, meron ka ma-advice?
Ako? Ang advice ko... wala pala.
Ako na sumagot.
Wala na pala ako advice.
Parang may gusto nang sabihin.
Sige. Wala na. So, dito na nag-end yung ating conversations with my cousin about long distance relationship.
Yes, and hopefully you guys picked up a thing or two from
nakakahiya. I'm sure. Yung mga ibang may LDR dyan, may mga better advice or like other advice, just leave it in the comments!
Yes! ano ba yun? Yung Facebook page na
We're going to flash it here kung ano yung page,
yung
na,
page
sinasabi
na sinasabi niya.
Sige.
Para makatulong din sa inyo. Kasi hindi namin alam yun eh, kaming dalawa.
That's actually a good tip for those who don't know about this this page. It may help you.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good. I just buy the new seat toilet.
The toilet seat. So that's why you weren't picking up.
Yes.
How are you? Are you keeping safe?
Yes, keeping safe. Yes, I have a tampon.
He went for a tampon. That's what they call the COVID swab test.
I hope you're wearing masks properly. Do you always wear your masks?
And alcohol?
Yes.
Where's your alcohol?
This is my helper here.
Okay. Where's the one from the Philippines?
Very, very good. That's the best. Okay, thanks, Luigi. We'll call you again soon, and I hope we see you soon. Bye. Kiss you.
Bye. I love you. Bye-bye.
What did you drink?
White wine.
Good.
Okay, bye. Take care.
Bye-bye, guys.
Bye. Oh, do you know what this is? That's our logo.
They want this for me.
You need to buy it.
Okay, bye, Luigi. Take care.
Okay, ciao. Bye.
Bye.
Ciao.
Okay, thank you for watching, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to us.
And hit the notification bell button.
So you get notified whenever we post a new video.
Ayun,
bye! Bye, KaTable!